الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين خاتم النبيين ورحمة للعالمين وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي اللهم اجعلنا دعاة إليك وإلى رسولك أما بعد فقد قال الله تعالى في كتابه الكريم أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم المال والبنون زينة الحياة الدنيا والباقيات الصالحات خير عند ربك ثوابا وخيرا أملا وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بلغوا عني ولو آية صدق الله العلي العظيم وصدق رسول الكريم ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين ومن الشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين Indeed all praises are for Allah and we praise Allah and we thank Allah we glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who is one مَنْ يَهْدِ اللَّهُ فَلَا مُذِلَّ لَهُ It is a fact that whoever Allah guides, no man can lead astray. وَمَنْ يُضْلِلْهُ فَلَا هَادِيَ لَهُ Whoever Allah leads to go astray, no one can guide that person. We testify that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent on the face of this earth approximately 124 prophets for the guidance of mankind. Adam alayhi salam being the first and Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the seal of the prophets, Khatimun Nabiyyin, the mercy to the world, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. My dear brothers, my dear sisters, alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. All praises are for Allah who is the Lord of the worlds. A new day has dawned upon us. Yawmul Jum'ah, the day of assembly, the best day in the sight of Allah. Such a day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had kept it sacred and special for the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is the day, khalaqallahu Adam alayhi salatu wa salam, that Allah created Adam alayhi salatu wa salam on this day. Wa daqal al jannah fihi. On this day, Adam alayhi salam, he entered into Jannah. On this day, Adam alayhi salam, wa kharaja minhu. He was exited from Jannah on this day. On this day, says Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it was the day that Adam alayhi salam stepped foot on earth. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, on this day shall occur the day of Qiyamah. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, on this day, the birds, the angels, the mountains, the fishes in the oceans, kulluhum yad'un Allah. All of them, they make dua to Allah. Yakhafuna min hadha al-yawm. They are afraid of this day because this is the day in which the day of Qiyamah is going to occur. What about insan? What about mankind? This is the day, my dear brothers, my dear sisters, Allah for himself, Allah Azza wa Jal, Allah Al-Ali, Allah the High One, Allah Al-Azim, Allah the Great One, Allah Al-Kabir, Allah Al-Malik, the King, the Owner, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for himself, in the Quran, he says, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, eh iman walo, O you who have iman, O you who have faith, O you who have proclaimed to believe in Allah as one, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا نُودِيَ لِلصَّلَاةِ مِيَوْمِ الْجُمْعَةِ When the call is proclaimed on the day of assembly, فَاسْعَوْا إِلَىٰ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ Hasten earnestly to the remembrance of Allah, the dhikr of Allah. فَاسْعَوْا إِلَىٰ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَذَّرُوا الْبَيْءِ Leave off trade, leave off business, because ذَلِكُمْ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ Because that is best for you if you only knew. Alhamdulillah, Allah has guided our hearts because we understand the ayat of the Quran, what is best for us. This is best for us if we only but knew. What it has in store in this hour that we will present ourselves in the house of Allah, for the sake of Allah, for the pleasure of Allah. In this hour, my dear brothers, my dear sisters, it doesn't even have to be an entire hour. For this moment, just the near of leaving our trade, leaving our homes, leaving our business, only the near, only the intention to come towards Allah's house, to respond to the call that Allah has made in the Quran, that niyyah alone, that intention alone is enough for the gates of paradise to be opened. Because innamal a'malu bin niyyat. Because the actions are judged by the intentions. The actions of a man is judged by the intention. So we make the niyyah, and subhanallah, for some reason or some reason or the other, we weren't able to present ourselves. We got a tire puncture, some accident on the road, may Allah forbid, no taxi to come. We couldn't present ourselves. The niyyah was so important that is what Allah took. That is all it takes. With ikhlas, with sincerity. We look at the rains falling from the skies. Today is a rainy day. And it brought to my mind, subhanallah, an ayat of the Quran. A very beautiful verse of the Quran that Allah speaks about the rains falling from the skies. Allah says in the glorious Quran, A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim, wadrib lahum mathal alhayatid dunya. Strike to them, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Present to them the similitude of the life of this world, the parable of the life of this world, the example of the life of this world. What is the similitude? Allah says, "Kama in anzalnahu minas sama." It's like the rains that fall from the skies. The life of this world, it's like the water, the rain that falls from the skies. It falls on the earth. What happens? فَاخْتَلَطَ بِهِ نَبَاتُ الْأَرْضِ. Subhanallah, it mixes with the earth. Whatever is in the earth, whatever from the seeds, the grains on the earth, it mixes with that. فَأَصْبَحَ حَشِيمًا نَذْرُوهُ رِيَاحٍ. When it mixes with the seeds of the earth, vegetations are produced, crops comes about, greenery, herbage, subhanallah, all the niceties of the earth now we see springing up. But then the Quran says, after a little while, this very crop that you see, the beautiful greenery in the leaves of the plants, the beautiful flowers that open with the droplets of the rain, after a little while, they will become dry. They will become dry in such a state, the breeze will blow and it will take them all away. It would look as though they were never there. They were never there. Allah says, وَكَانَ اللَّهُ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ مُقْتَدِرًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is able to do every single thing. What does it mean? The life of a child, it starts with a drop of water, a mingled drop of sperm. The rain represents the life that is starting. The child comes on the face of the earth. The child is coming from the sky, the similitude. The rain, the water, the drop, it represents that child. Comes on the face of the earth. From the moment it comes out, it is being nourished. That child is being nourished. It drinks the milk from the mommy. It eats the little food. That child becomes fresh, green, strong in his youth. This is the plants. This is the herbage. This is the cultivation. This is the crop we see. Insan. Strong and nice and fresh and green. But then after a while, that very child is going to become old. It's going to walk with the hand on the back. The bones going to start to hurt. The hair on the face is going to start to turn gray. The hair on the head is going to become gray. The eyes are going to become wrinkled. The sight of the eyes, you'll start to see blurry. The hearing now, you have to talk to a person 10 times. What happened? You're deaf. You can't hear properly now. Old age, just like the plant that was green, now it has become dried. The breeze blow, scatter them apart, and just they disappear. Malakul Maut will come, snatch us, and we will just disappear under the earth. Allah sets forth an example. Why? Because Allah wants us to become aware. Allah wants us not to attach ourselves with the life of this world, to understand it very well, that it's going to come to an end. Your life is going to come to an end. The freshness, the greenery, the youth, the health, the strength, it's going to disappear. What's going to remain? The other ayah tells us. The beauty of the Quran. The beauty of the Quran. While we are here, all this rain has fallen. The crops have become green, fresh and nice. Allah says, "Al-malu wa banun zinatun, zinatul hayatid dunya." Al-malu wa banun, wealth, the wealth, the children, they are a zina, they are beautification for the life of this world. Ask anybody. We take pride in our businesses. We take pride in our wealth. We take pride in our children. We call them the coolness of our eyes. They are a zina. They are an attraction. They are beautification for the life of this world. What else is there? We work to receive some kind of wealth, some kind of money. And subhanAllah, we go forth, we reproduce our wives, they reproduce children. They become comforting to us. When we see them starting to walk, when we see them starting to smile, the first word that comes out of their mouth, the first step that they take, the first day that they go to kindergarten school, the first day that they go to primary, our children, subhanAllah, we call them the beauty or the pride of our lives. Allah is saying that your wealth and your children, they are zinatul li hayatid dunya. Beautification for the life of this world. But are they going to last forever? Are our children going to stay here forever? Are we going to stay forever? Is our wealth going to stay here forever? Subhanallah. Look at the ayats Allah brings. Allah says, "Wal baqiyatu salihat khayrun 'inda rabbik." Allah says, but the remaining righteous deeds, that is what is best in the sight of your Lord. Not the wealth, not the children, but the remaining righteous deeds. But the wealth can help. The children can also help. That is best in the sight of your Lord. Thawaban wa khayrun amala. Subhanallah. It is best in the sight of your Lord in gaining rewards and better in respect of hoping from Allah. Two things. The good deeds, the good righteous deeds, they are the best thing that anybody can do on the face of the earth. No children will be able to help us on the day of Qiyamah. يَوْمَ يَفِرُّ الْمَرْءُ مِنْ أَخِيهِ. On the day, a man will run away from his brother. That is the day of Qiyamah. وَأُمِّهِ وَأَبِيهِ. He will run from his mother, from his father. وَصَاحِبَتِهِ وَبَنِي. He will run from his wife, he will run from his children. لِكُلِّ امْرِئٍ مِّنْهُمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ شَأْنُ يُغْنِي. On that day it's all about himself. Everybody's looking at their own affairs. Me. The wealth is not going to be of any avail. The only thing that is going to help us on that day, the only thing, is the righteous good deeds that we left on the face of the earth, and the righteous good deeds that we did, Allah stored it up for us in the akhirat. Commenting on what are the righteous good deeds that last. The righteous good deeds that last. Not like the children, not like the wealth, because it will not last. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he mentions many different ahadith commenting on this ayah from Hafiz Ibn Kathir alayhi rahmah, Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala an, Sa'id ibn Jubayr radiallahu ta'ala an, and others from amongst the Salaf al-Salih, They have written that the righteous good deeds that Allah is speaking about in this ayah of the Quran, it's the 5 daily salah. The 5 daily prayer. This is the righteous good deeds that would last. It would last. In other words, when you perform your salah, it goes towards your Jannah. It goes towards your Akhirat, your heaven. When you don't perform it, it goes there too, but it goes against you. So you'll end up in Jahannam when you don't do it. Some others from amongst the Salaf al-Saleh and the Mufassirin of the Quran, all these are taken from Hafiz Ibn Kathir, his commentary of the ayah. He says, the righteous good deeds that last, they are no big thing, no difficult thing. It's very simple. It's the utter, Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar. And that's it. Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar. That is the righteous good deeds. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal in his Musnad, the hadith comes where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentions, Bakbak li kamsin, ma athqalahunna fil mizan. He says, well done, bravo, bravo, for 5 things. How heavy these 5 things will be upon the mizan. How strong, how weighty these 5 things will be upon the scale on the day of Qiyamah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, what are those 5 things? La ilaha illallah. Placed on the pan, on the scale, on the scales on the day of Qiyamah. Put the world and everything it contains. This one kalima, La ilaha illallah, is going to outweigh it all. La ilaha illallah. That is the first thing. It's going to be weighty on the scale. Wallahu Akbar. And saying Allahu Akbar. The second thing. The third thing. Subhanallah. Glory be to Allah. The fourth. Walhamdulillah. And saying Alhamdulillah. All praises are for Allah. The fifth. Walwaladu salih yutawaffa fayahtasibuhu waliduhu. A righteous child, he passes away and his parents seeks hope from Allah for the reward from Allah based on the upbringing of this child, that he was a righteous child. These 5 things, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying, well done. Well done to who? For those people who will put it into practice, because it will become heavy on the scales on the day of Qiyamah. Saying La ilaha illallah. Ask ourselves now, how often do we moist our tongues with La ilaha illallah? How often do we moist our tongues with Allahu Akbar? How often do we moist our tongues with Subhanallah? How often do we moist our tongues with Alhamdulillah? How often do we moist our tongues with saying La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah? This is coming in the other part. Righteous son, the 5th thing. The hadith continues. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam continues and he says, وَقَالَ بَقْ بَقْ. He says, well done, لِخَمْسٍ, for 5 things. مَنْ لَقِيَ اللَّهُ مُسْتَيْقِنًا بِهِنَا دَقَلَ الْجَنَّةِ. He says, whoever meets Allah with iman in Allah, with yaqeen in Allah, with faith in Allah, with hope in Allah, then this person will enter into Jannah. These 5 things. Whoever meets Allah in regards to these 5 things, hoping in Allah, faith in Allah, Allah will what? Admit him in Jannah. The first, he says, Yu'minu billah, that he has iman in Allah. The first thing, the first pillar of Islam, We can perform salat, which is the second. We can give zakat, which is the third. We can fast in Ramadan, which is the fourth. We can perform hajj, which is the fifth pillar of Islam. But if we don't have the first pillar of Islam, then nothing matters in the sight of Allah. What is the first pillar of Islam? To have total and complete faith in Allah as being one. La ilaha illallah. There is nothing, there is no one deserving to be worshipped except Allah. Not when it's time for salah, I would listen to my wife and stay home and I will not pray. I would listen to the husband and I will not pray. I will sit behind the television and I will not pray. Not that type of iman we are speaking about. That when it's time for prayer, because my iman is on la ilaha illallah, I would leave everything. Every single thing. This is the iman. So that one who meets Allah with this certainty, with this reality, with this type of iman, hoping for the rewards in Allah, based on this iman that he has, he will enter Jannah. Belief in Allah. Belief in Allah. Don't just feel it's just a simple thing by saying la ilaha illallah. We have to be convicted. It has to be coming from the heart. What is la ilaha illallah? What is this la ilaha illallah? La ilaha illallah ufniya biha amri. La ilaha illallah adkhul biha qabri. La ilaha illallah atlu biha wahdi. La ilaha illallah alqa biha rabbi. Whenever, subhanallah, Buraira, a woman she used to say from amongst the saints, a very righteous and pious woman, La ilaha illallah ufniya bi amri. My entire life will be lived based on this kalima. Whether it's good, whether it's bad, whatever the situation, La ilaha illallah will see me through. Whether my child is taken, whether my wife, my husband is taken, whether the wealth is taken, whatever the situation, La ilaha illallah, I would live my life with this kalima. Whether I have wealth, whether I don't have wealth, I would live my life with La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah, adqul biha qabri. Even when I die, I will go into my grave with this kalima. La ilaha illallah, because it will be the last thing that will come from the tongues of the believers, and it will be the first thing to come out from the mouths of the believers. La ilaha illallah. Adkul biha qabri. I will enter my qabr with la ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah. Atlu biha wahdi. When I am in solitude, when I am alone, I will always proclaim la ilaha illallah. It will not be about this show. It will not be about that show. It will not be about this brother or this sister or this thing and that thing. It will be la ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah alqa biha rabbi. When I stand before my Rabb on the day of Qiyamah, when I stand before Allah on the day of Qiyamah, the first thing I will throw in front of Allah, alqa, the first thing I will meet Allah with is la ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying, bak bak, well done, well done. He comes in for five things. That one who will meet Allah on the day of Qiyamah with firm faith in Allah, he will be made to enter Jannah. The one who believes in Allah, believes in Allah. The second, wal yawm al akhir, he believes that the day of Qiyamah is coming. The last day, it's coming. When we say believe, our beliefs must be accompanied with something called amal, actions. What kind of iman do we have when we believe in Allah? We believe in the day of judgment, but still we are not performing salat. We are not giving zakat. We are not nice to our friends, not nice to the neighbors, not kind to our relatives, not kind to the parents, not dutiful to the parents. Subhanallah. What kind of iman is that? And we say we believe in the day of Qiyamah. Do we understand what are the punishments that are waiting there for us? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us through Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam the type of iman that Allah wants from us. The type of iman. So the first thing, belief in Allah, the day of judgment. Wal jannata wan nar, to believe in jannat and to believe in jahannam. Believe in paradise, believe in the fire. What kind of beliefs we have about these things? Today we only see Jannah. We are only speaking about Jannah, only the paradise. I want to go to paradise. I want to go to paradise. We are not even making preparation for death. We even reach Jannah. We ain't talking Jannah. We talking about the first stage, the Qabristan. We have not even been making preparation to meet Allah through mouth, through death. Because today we live as though we're not going to die. Every single day this Qabristan is calling out. Every single day. And abaytul dud, and abaytul zulma, and abaytul wahda, and abaytul wakhsha, fasta'iddu qabla an ta'tiya ilayya. I am the house of worms. I am the home of insects. I am the home of darkness. I am the home of solitude. Prepare yourselves, O insan, before you come to me. Prepare yourselves, O insan, before you come to me. Today we are talking about everything. Everything else except death. That's sure reality. Investigate ourselves. Ask ourselves. Search ourselves and we will see these words that we speak today, they are no lies. We check the business, the account of the business. We check what we have to do for the day. We check how we're going to spend the night. We check how we're going to spend the other day. We never even think for once, tonight can be my last night. What am I going to do tomorrow when I stand before Allah? What am I going to do tomorrow when I lie in the bowels of the earth? No preparations for that. Nothing about inheritance, wife or husband. This is how you have to distribute my wealth. This is what you have to do after I die. Oh, my son, this is what you have to do after I die. Daughters, this is what you have to do after I die. Nothing like that. No preparation at all. These are the realities of life. This is the third thing, to believe in the heaven, believe in the fire. The fourth thing says Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, wal ba'thi ba'da al maut, resurrection after death. Allah is going to bring us back. Allah is going to bring us back. Don't think that it is impossible. Some from amongst the Quraysh, they came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It is mentioned in Surah Yasin. They took up the bones, the rotted bones of an animal that had disintegrated. They took it and they squashed it and squeezed it in their hands and threw it in the face of the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam like thus. They say, are you telling us Allah is going to bring back this to life? Subhanallah. Subhanallah. Allah says in the Quran, فَإِنَّمَا إِذَا أَرَادَ شَيْئًا فَإِنَّمَا يَقُولُ لَهُ كُنْ فَيَكُونَ. Whenever Allah wants anything, if ever, all Allah says to it, be, fayakun, it becomes. Just be, it becomes. وَالْبَعْثِ بَعْدَ الْمَوْتِ, the resurrection after death. It's going to happen. And guess what? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, you see, death, it's not only about how you live, it's also about how you die. This is why the Quran says, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu taqullah. O you who have iman. Again, iman walo, fear your Lord. Haqqa tuqatihi, as he ought to be feared. Wa la tamutunna illa wa antum muslimun. Don't let death come to you. Don't let death meet you. Don't let death overtake you. Except that you're in a state of submission to Allah. In a state of submission to Allah. What did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam say? Yub'athu kullu abdin ala ma mata alayhi. Every servant of Allah, every slave of Allah, he is going to be raised on the day of Qiyamah in whatever condition he died. It's not only about how you live, it's about how you die too. You can live your entire life with iman, and at that point in time, iman can be taken from you. You can live your entire life without iman, and at that point in time, Allah can send hidayah. Where was Abu Talib? Where was Abu Talib when Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was presenting kalima to him? He was lying on his deathbed. On his deathbed. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, Chacha, oh my uncle, only proclaim this kalima, I will intercede for you on the day of Qiyamah. Where was he? On the deathbed. Had he mentioned, had he proclaimed, had he testified, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa annaka Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam would have been made to intercede for him on the day of Qiyamah. So it's not only about how we live, it's about how we die also. The fifth thing says Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, wal hisab, to believe that we have to give an account on the day of Qiyamah. We have to give an account on the day of Qiyamah. Today we can hide it here, because when we work and you get some work to do and you have to complete this for the day, you have to give an account. These are the job specs and this is what you have to do. We have to give an account to the boss. We have to report to the boss. Some things we hide. Some things we sweep under the carpet and we still write it on the paper, I did it. Yeah. Not so with Allah. Not so with Allah. We will see on the day of Qiyamah, Mali hadal kitab, what is wrong with this book? What is wrong with this book? This book has not left out a simple thing, no big thing, no small thing. Everything in this book is written. All our deeds. All our deeds. You can run, but you can't hide. So Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying, these five things, anybody brings iman in these five things, certainty in these five things, yakin, firm belief, he will enter Jannah. This belief in Allah, believe in Allah, believe in the day of Qiyamah, believe in heaven and hell, believe in the resurrection after death, and believe in the accountability. The accountability. And these beliefs must be accompanied with our actions. Our actions must show that I believe in this. If I believe that I'm going in hell if I backbite, then I have to stop backbiting. Otherwise, it doesn't show that I believe I will go in hell. I can backbite anybody and get away because there is no hell for me. That is what I'm saying. If I believe, if I rob somebody, I'm dishonest with somebody, I cheat somebody, I'm a fraud, I'm dealing in bribery, all these different things which carries the punishment of hell, and I'm still dealing in it, it shows in my action. I don't really believe in that. The hadith is saying, well done, well done. Not for that person who only proclaimed it, but that person who lived it. Some of the other commentaries of the righteous good deeds that will last. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, as a matter of fact, the hadith comes from Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. From the tafsir of Imam Jarir, from Imam Qurtubi. He says, this righteous good deeds that would last, it refers to righteous daughters. Your girl children. The pious girl children that you will have. And Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she says, based on that, she said, she said that the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, I saw a man on the day of Qiyamah, when he was made to visit Jannat and Jahannam on the night of Ascension. I saw a man, it was ordered for him to be dragged into hell. Ordered for him to be dragged into hell. While this order was being carried on, I saw some girls grabbed onto his leg and they started to cry and they started to weep. And they started to beg Allah, oh Allah, oh Allah, irhamhu, irhamhu, have mercy upon him, have mercy upon him. Hatha abina, hatha abina, this is our father, this is our father. He looked at us, he took care of us in our family. He raised us with good akhlaq, he raised us with piety, he raised us with taqwa. Oh Allah, save our father, and forgive our father. Free him from this place called hell. The hadith ended. Wa ghafara Allahu lahu. Allah forgave him. Allah forgave him. So those of us who have daughters, train them well, raise them well, teach them good morals, good akhlaq, good mannerism. If we didn't have any daughters, well then alhamdulillah, it could apply to sons too. To sons too. So these, my dear brothers, my dear sisters, this is what has been explained. These are not my words. These are the words of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. These are the words of the great commentators of the Quran. These are the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What are the righteous good deeds that's going to last? And these are all the different translation and commentary that has been given towards it. So let us not be fooled, lest we think al-mal wal-banun, that it's our wealth and it's our children, they're going to help us, they're going to save us. Let's not think like that. The good deeds that last. And these are the deeds that last. In some other narrations, the hadith come that it means all the good things that a person will do that Allah becomes pleased with. All the good things according to the Sharia of Islam. What Islam says is good. Remember, وَمَا تُقَدِّمُوا لِأَنفُسِكُمْ تَجِدُوهُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. Whatever good you send forth for your souls, you will find it with Allah. هُوَ خَيْرًا وَأَعْظَمَ أَجْرًا. It will be better, greater in rewards, everlasting. وَاسْتَغْفِرَ اللَّهِ. So seek Allah's forgiveness. إِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. Allah is all-forgiving, most merciful. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us. May He continue to guide us. May He show us truth as truth, falsehood as falsehood. May Allah guide our hearts towards al-haq, towards the truth. وَالْآخِرُ دَعْوَانَا أَنِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ.